My name is Bjorn Englen. I came to Los Angeles in 1993, started MI's program about 2 weeks after I arrived. I felt right at home immediately, meeting kids from all over the world. I grew up in completely different countries. I grew up in Sweden. It was just mind-blowing how similar we were. I've been in town for a very long time now, and about 6 months after I graduated, I get a call from the band Quiet Riot, and they said, "Hey man, that sounds great, come in for an audition." They got 120 demo tapes, and they had 40 bass players come in and play, and then they pretty much asked me right away, "Hey, do you want to tour with us?" I'm like, "Sure." I've never toured before, and they said, "Oh, don't worry about it, you'll get the hang of it in a couple of days, you know." Just went on and played, did a lot of sessions in the 90s and worked all over the studios when there were still studios in Los Angeles. Now I do a lot of tracks from home, and that's awesome too, but in a different way. You know, it's very social, and you know, I get to meet new musicians and stuff like that all the time, so it was great. My playing, I think, came from growing up with Steve Harris and Billy Sheehan especially, but I think bass players in the 60s and the 70s were playing more, and they were playing not just more walking and moving bass lines, but they're also playing guitar parts and filling up the empty space. And that sort of like always inspired me. And that's what I always wanted to be. A good bass player locks in with a drummer. A great bass player is really conscious about serving the song and giving justice to the song and the music. Also connecting with the audience, I think, is important. You know, when I perform, I like to go to the edge of the stage and all the way up front and look at people and engage, and I think that's important. People come to see you as well as hearing you. I'll tell anyone that, you know, the school's awesome, but you're in school your whole life, you know, and you learn when you're working so much, and it's really important to, as soon as you graduate, go and get gigs and play, you know, and play live and in the studio, you know. You learn from working, basically. I think for a session player, especially, a freelancing musician, it's the best city in the world to be in. Despite the fact that a lot of studios have shut down and everything, it's still the recording mecca of the world and touring mecca. A lot of bands are based out of here. They rehearse here before they go on tour. So if you're here, I think you're more likely to get hired. One thing that I think is important is to know how to read charts. And it's something that I got really used to at MI. So when people would give me charts, it would be like easy for me to follow a chart, you know, and I think that's very important. Sometimes you have maybe one day to learn 20 songs is almost impossible. So you have to chart things out. People say, "Hey, can you play a gig tomorrow?" Sure, and you chart it out and you read it. Teachers were telling me, they're like, "Well, you're a great rock player, but come to the jazz class or you know, jazz band class," or whatever they were called, and they said, "Just check it out and sit in and play a few songs." And I think just opening your mind to different styles will help you, regardless of the style of music you play. It'll help you play, and it'll open up your mind in different directions, rhythmically or harmony-wise.